If you've seen the movie Coach Carter, you remember the scene where Samuel L. Jackson's character walks in the gym and introduces himself to his new players for the first time. He says something like, "If you want to see my credentials, they're hanging on the wall behind you." And you look and they show the wall and it's got all of the school banners. And Samuel L. Jackson's character, Coach Carter, has all the school records. Points, assists, rebounds, he's got some state championship banners hanging up, all that stuff. Coach Carter is saying, "Look, I know basketball. I played basketball and I won." Instantly, he got the players' attention. Because when a coach walks in and they can prove that they know how to play the game and that they did play the game and they played at the highest level, immediately they're gonna have your attention. I'm not saying that if you didn't play at a high level, you can't coach. Because a lot of the best coaches actually weren't as physically gifted, but understood the mental side of the game, and that's why they make such a good coach. But I'm telling you, if you can prove that you were good by playing the game, you're gonna have their attention. I remember when I was in ninth grade on the basketball team, and we got a new coach, and honestly, he didn't look very athletic. And honestly, he didn't look like the kind of guy that would be good at basketball. But in our first practice, he was showing us these shooting drills. Almost every shot he took went in. And immediately, I remember as a ninth grader thinking, this guy can coach me. I'll listen to what he has to say because I know that he can play the game of basketball. And whether that's right or wrong doesn't matter. That's human nature, right? When you know that they can play the game, you're gonna listen to them. If he'd been missing those shots and wasn't making them, I'd be like, how are you gonna tell me how to play basketball when you clearly can't do it yourself? The old cheesy cliche saying is, God is our coach. Well, if God is our coach, then we have a coach who played the game. And not just played the game, but was the best to ever do it. Today's Christmas Day, and it's the day that we celebrate the birth of Jesus Christ. This is the day that God himself came down to earth and wrapped himself in human flesh. When Jesus walked on this earth, he did so as a man. Hebrews 4 says that he was tempted in every way and didn't sin. Well, what does that mean? For me, it means two things. It means one, God understands us. When we walk on this earth, when we go through struggles, through temptations, when we sin, when we make mistakes, God understands the struggle because he was there, because he lived it. He knows what it's like to be a human being on this earth and everything that goes with it, right? All of the temptations, all of the struggles, it's not like he can't relate. It's not like God's up in heaven saying, come on, man, like how do you make this mistake again? Like he understands what we're going through because he went through it himself. The second thing that means to me is that he overcame it. So he struggled like we did, but he overcame it. He was tempted in every way, it says, but he didn't sin. So if he knows what it's like to be tempted, but can overcome it, then he can help us overcome it as well. I'm not saying we're gonna be perfect like Jesus, because none of us will be, right? We're all gonna make mistakes. We're all gonna fall sometimes. But that doesn't mean we can't pursue perfection. That doesn't mean that we just have to accept the sin in our life. Because our example of how to live on this earth was able to overcome every temptation he faced. We can go to him with our struggles and our sins and our temptations because he can relate. He knows what it's like and he's not up in heaven mad at us, judging us, like, how could you do that? He understands, he relates to us, but he also overcame that, which means when we go to him, he can give us the answers. He can give us the same power that Jesus had when he was on this earth, has been given to us, and he can give us the same power to overcome temptations in life. So when you're struggling, when you're going through something, go to him. Ask him for help, ask him for wisdom, for advice, for the strength and the power to get through what you're going through. Not only did our coach play the game, not only did he play at the highest level, he was undefeated. He came out on top. So when you're in a bad situation, when you're struggling, when you're tempted, don't try to do it yourself. Talk to your coach, ask him for some advice, and ask for the power to overcome it. This is like having Tom Brady as your quarterback coach. It's like having Reggie Miller or Ray Allen as your shooting coach. So this Christmas, I just want to encourage you that Jesus came on this earth, lived as a man, lived the perfect life to overcome sin, so that now whatever sin and struggle you're going through, you have someone that you can talk to and he can help you through it and also give you the power, not just the advice, but the power to overcome whatever sin, struggle, trial, temptation you could be going through.